Hi, I've got a lovely background card today for you, showing off the Pacific Ocean background and a lovely way to make the flowers out of vellum. We are going to be using the Petite Lavish Sentiments for our sentiment. That's a clear stamp set by Creative Expressions. Here are the striped nasturtiums. And this is the Pacific Ocean Collection background. And we're just going to be layering that up, and I'll show you a really nice way to do this. And I'm going to do a little bit of accenting with the lace-edged leaves around our flowers. And this is what we'll be using in today's video, is the vellum. And that'll look lovely with our background and in our flowers. So we'll do a bit of cutting first off. I've got a piece of wisteria card, and I'll give you a quick measurement. It is 5 1/8 by 7 1/8. And we're going to use the outer die on the background. Now, the dies don't have any cutting edge around the outside, so you can have a nice border if you like, or you can have it a little bit closer to the edge. So it depends on where you want your border. I think it's quite pretty to have that border. So centering it right in the middle with a little bit going around the edge, I think is a beautiful way to do it. Pop that onto our cutting plate. And this is a rather large die. So what I recommend doing, if you can, is just give it a little tilt. So as it goes through, it's hitting a bottom section first in a corner rather than the whole die altogether. Roll it through. Roll it back. Let's check and see if it needs another pass. That looks very good. Let me give it a quick run with the tool in one, take out the bits. There we go. And untape it. Get those last little pieces out. There we go. Okay. And we've got almost all of those out of there. A couple little bits with the pokey tool. There's a few here. There we go. So you can see some gorgeous detail in that. So what we're going to do is we are going to put a vellum behind that. So let's just tidy a little bit. Bring in vellum. So ordinarily I would back it with another color behind that, but I want to have kind of a translucent look to it. So we'll just bring our glue in. Do a little bit of gluing here. And around the edge. Put our vellum into place. So you can see you've got a really soft look coming through the decorative cutout areas in that. Now I've got one I've done ahead of time. Now the other thing I recommend is putting a backing on that, and that will actually give you a little bit more of that glow coming through. So we're going to go ahead and use this one. Done some matting and layering here. So I've brought in the pierced edge I love, and I've used a little bit of wisteria as a mat. So I'll bring that color in. Pop that into place. Yeah, looks good. So now we can do the next one. So I'm going to bring this back over, and this is done in sections, so you have a cut edge in between, and we are going to set this one up with the decorative edge and the outside cutting edge. And let's just use a bit of this tape. Center it. That looks pretty good. There we go. Pop that down. Put that on and give it a quick run through. Okay. Clean out the fall away. Take the tape off. And you can see another gorgeous piece to the background. So we bring this vellum in, seated on the back of that, and we have a very similar look. So we're going to go and continue upward, and I've got one I've already done. Put a little bit of white card on the back just so it has the same look going forward. So let's bring our piece back in. And we can stack that in the middle. I've got some mounting foam on it. That fits right in the middle of that background. And I've done the exact same thing with the centerpiece here in the middle of that. So it's done in three sections. We're going to just build it up so we have a gorgeous dimensional background to work from. So now what I want to do is I want to accent this with some flowers. So I've gone ahead and I've cut the striped nasturtiums out of vellum. So a couple of them here, let me show you. And I've got a bit of it already done, but what you want to do is cut two for each section and just do a little bit of pinching between your finger and your thumb. Give it a little bit of a scrunch across, just like that. Almost like an accordion. You're just kind of folding it back and forth, scrunching it. Pinch it, scrunch it. There we go. And there's no right or wrong way here. And you just want to get a little bit of dimension to that. I'm going to add some glue to the center. Set that up for a second. And do this one. Give it a little bit of fold. I'm just using my fingernails to kind of fold it around, tuck it back and forth, like I said, in sort of an accordion fashion. Here we go. So it'll look quite messy, but that's exactly how you want it to look. Just gives it a little bit of a scrunchy look to it. So I'm going to pop that into place, offsetting from the first one. Hold it for a second. And don't worry about the glue showing through the vellum, because that center will be covered with a pearl. There we go. Put another one in here. And you can build them up. This is the next size down. I've done exactly the same thing. So you can just pop that in the center, build that up. Give it a second to glue. You can do the smaller one, add your pearl in the center of that, and you've got this really gorgeous flower. Very soft from the vellum, so it's not a solid look to it. So I've done these in three different sizes. And you can just add extra bits to it if you want it a little fuller, a little more roughly. Rather than just doing two or three or four, you can do six of them. Totally your call, however you want to do that. So we'll go ahead and seat those onto a piece of satin ribbon that we've tied into a messy bow. And I'm going to put that on with a glue dot right in the corner, just under that second section there. I'm going to pop the larger of the flowers on that with a glue dot right there. We'll seat the other two directly opposite in the upper corner. It's a nice balance to have the large and the small flowers opposite each other. There we go. And now what we'll do is we'll add in some of our lace edge leaves here, so I can trim these down a tiny bit to use on the smaller bit of the flowers. Pop that right underneath those. There we go. I can even use the little bits that I've cut out of there if I want to add in some extra bits. There we go. Pop that around there. And we'll do a larger one on the bottom here, just coming out from underneath the flower, but on top of the ribbon. There we go. Nice little accent there. And like I said, you can use some of these smaller bits to put under the tops of the corners if you like. No waste whatsoever. Coming out from around there. In fact, let's move this one. Let's trim that just a little bit shorter. Trim that off. There we go. And we'll do one more here. Let's use this one. Pop that right under there. And we're going to finish it off with a sentiment. And I've just used the very center oval from the background to cut my sentiment, stamped in black, a little bit of mounting foam, and it seats right in the center. So add some pearls to that to finish it off, and you have a really beautiful background card. Love the way the vellum just is so soft and delicate looking, don't you? Hope you've enjoyed today's video, and don't forget our YouTube channel has so many more videos on it for you to see and subscribe to it.